restaurants. I love that. I'm like, you can immediately see the chef faces. Like, I could, like, I'm like, you know how they say, like, it's gold, the smell of, like.
Sorry, it's a late start. Apparently, David O'Doherty set fire to the venue because he, quotes, is too much of a pussy to finish his own show. That's what I've heard. That's the rumours going around. The official line is, there was a fire alarm in the middle of his show. I'm divisive, that's what I'll say. I'm divisive. I can divide a single news organisation. The Times of London newspaper in the last half decade has described me as being both one of the most talented young comedians we have and a left-leaning comedian whose stock in trade appears to be biting the hand that feeds him. Now, that second comment doesn't come from a comedy review. It comes from an op-ed piece written by a journalist who happened to see me give a performance at an event that he thought was disgusting and offensive. The name of the event, I promise you this is true, the Freedom of Expression Awards.
No.
Salty.
There it is, Peter. Your impatience has paid off.
Sometimes I watch the clouds, they're begging to be stared at. They say my thoughts aloud, they never used to do that. My dreams smell just like pine, like something once forgotten. They feel just like they're mine, but the wind blows them like cotton. The rivers gave me my blue eyes, the trees inspired me to grow. I feel so young that I could cry. I feel like indigo. Indigo. Drive along the hills, I don't think I'll ever forget the way they rolled. It gave me chills that I'm not ready to admit. And we would leap into the lake, and our breath was briefly stolen. We didn't know the splash we'd made, or how our world would soon be swollen. The rivers gave me my blue eyes. The trees inspired me to grow. I feel so young that I could cry. I feel like indigo.